Simbonile, Simbonile, Esinakeke, Simbonile, 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 Esinakeke, Simbonile.
Simbonile,
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 Thank you. 거의 것이 있을
Jesus. Jesus. Up your voice and tell him to worship you. I live. That's all you say.
To worship you. I live. We say to worship you. I live to worship you.
Come on, lift up your voice and tell him to worship you. I live, oh God.
To worship you. I live. To worship.
We say you've got to tell him to worship you. I live, oh God,
to worship you. I live,
we say
to worship you. I live to worship you.
After you have said that, the only thing you can say is to say, Lord, oh. Come on, lift up your voice.
Oh, we say, oh.
Mongasas go to Tinigu in Versut.
Oh,
Mongasas itinjegu,
yeah.
Join me, home. Puria me mendere, me meschiri hasta la mamande, puria mamma schiri hasta la mamande, me meschiri anda la mamande, schiri hasta. Oh,
Put your hands together for Jesus. Hallelujah. We bless his wonderful name. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So just as we're about to sit, we just want to do this one song that says, Vreugde klokke in your heart. Peace bells in your heart. And then it says, Neem die heiland waar jy gaan. So take the Savior with you wherever you go. Neem hom waar jy sit of staan. So take him whether you're sitting or you standing. You take the Savior with you. And then it says, Dan lei hy die vrede klokke in your heart. Then he will place peace bells in your heart. So on this Mother's Day, we're saying as women, we carry a lot. But if you can take the Savior with you, acknowledge him in all your ways, then he will give you peace that surpasses all understanding. Hallelujah. Let's go. Sambe mzalwane. If you have to take off your shoes, take off your shoes, mama.
Fear the clock in your heart.
Give me halo.
Give me halo, Maria. Thank you, worship team. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. I will rejoice, I will be glad and be glad. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad indeed. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has.
Oh, I will rejoice and be glad. This is the day, this is the day.
Praise the Lord. Welcome to KBC this morning. We are the church with open arms. Hallelujah. Psalm 133 church. Behold how good and how pleasant it is when brethren dwell together in unity. The Bible says the Lord declares and sends life and blessing every day or in their midst. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Now, as KBC, we come together at 7:30 until 8 o'clock. It's a prayer session. It's intercession. So we would encourage you, because if you can be here at 7:30, you will never have a problem with starting the service at 8 o'clock. Amen. So we always start our services with prayer. Now, the children's church is on. The children's church is on in the office block. So if you have a little one that you are bringing to church with, just ask where the children's church is. They will show you, and that is where the children are taught the word of God at their level so that they can understand the beauty of this God that we serve. Jesus said, "Forbid not the children to come unto me." Amen. Glory to Jesus. Yeah, they know about Jesus when they are young. They will not deny Jesus when they are older. There'll be no new convert classes today. Ask your neighbor, Humaning. All right, I hope they gave you the right answer. So there'll be no new and be with us there on the Wednesday fellowships. Now, on Saturdays, we pray here at 6 a.m. until 7 a.m. Men come here to pray. Men come here to pray. Please, if you are a man in this church and you have never been there in the morning to pray, please, we ask you to come. Whether you do it once a month or you do it twice in a month, at least come and pray. Especially our youngsters, please, you need to develop a lifestyle of prayer from when you are young. You're going to need prayer more the older you get. The older you get, you're going to need to have that intimate time with the Lord. Start now and come to those prayer meetings. We are in here at 6 and 7 o'clock sharp. We are out. So, fathers, bring your sons, and sons, bring your fathers. Amen. Glory to Jesus. We want to thank those who were here for the Ascension Day service. Was that good? Oh, we had such a wonderful service here on Wednesday, on Thursday. And if you missed it and you have a Facebook page, you go to your Facebook page, check there what happened on that day, but also please follow that message. Many people don't realize how much Jesus spoke about his time of going to the Father. You know, Jesus came to save the world. He came to start the church. But Jesus knew that the biggest impact that the church will do is when he is ascended and seated at the right hand of the Father. Because that's where he gives the church the gifts. That is from there where he pours the Holy Spirit upon the church. It is from there that Jesus empowers the church to have impact. Amen. So please just check that, and then that message will really, really bless you. Now, home cell leaders, we are going to have our monthly fellowship here with the home cell leaders, and it's going to be this Monday from 6:30. You know that. So this Monday, 6:30, we're going to have our home cell leaders meeting. And then on Tuesday, all the home cells that are under Pastor Ngubeni, Pastor Griba, and Pastor Kodisang will be having their joint fellowship here in the church, here in the chapel, from 5 o'clock until 6 o'clock. So it is people who are in Zone 17, Zone 14, Zone 13, Zone 11, Zone 12, Zone 10, and people that are in Beverly Hills and people that are in Mkelele. So they'll all be meeting here because it will be your joint fellowship. And I hear that those joint fellowships are such a blessing. Make an arrangement transport-wise. If you do not have transport and you're going to need transport after the service, collate yourself in a group so that after that meeting you will be able to be shuttled back home. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, church, remember that our prayer and fasting week is coming from the 20th of May, that will be a Monday, up to the 24th of May, which will be a Friday. So, Monday, you will be doing the fasting, being at home, but from Tuesday until Thursday, we will be having our services here in the church. And those services will be 1.5 hours only. It will be from 5 p.m. until 6:30 p.m. All we will be doing, we're going to give a short word of exhortation, and then we go straight into prayer. This is a very crucial time for the church to be praying for the nation. Our country is coming into that very crucial time again. For the past 30 years, the Lord has given us elections without incident. Amen. Are there South Africans in here in this place? The Lord has given us elections without incident. Elections are never easy in any country, because when elections come, that's when you see people's egos flaring up. That's when you see people's schemes and things they do just to win an election. Elections can plunge a country into a time of conflict, war, or internal battles. So the Lord has been gracious to us. And on this 30th year, we are at a very crucial time as a nation. So we need to pray that the Lord will carry us through until we enter into another era of governance. Amen. So that Friday of that week of prayer and fasting, we will have our night prayer here. We'll have our night prayer here. And we would love to ask you to come and be with us in that night prayer. The night prayer will start from 10 p.m. and then until the wee hours of the morning on Saturday. Now, we know that the circumstances outside are not favorable. So we will encourage you, if you want to come to the night prayer and you don't have transportation, please leave home early and be here maybe about 6 o'clock or whatever. Enjoy the surrounding of the church here, and then at 10 o'clock we will start. Are we together? So as regarding fasting and prayer, we will be fasting, and Pastor Veronica has gone at length to explain to you how we will carry this entire time of fasting. Fast the whole week in accordance with the strength that the Lord gives you. Fast the entire week in accordance with how the Lord will guide you. And if it will be your first time fasting, please find an older Christian. I hope that Christian is one who knows how to fast. Find an older Christian. Let them explain to you, what do you do when you are fasting? Are we together? Amen, 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 amen. All right, today is Mother's Day. Today is Mother's Day. Come on, let's hear some shouts. Let's hear some ululating. Let's hear the men saying, my daughter. Let's hear the men saying, bo mama. Glory to Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's hear the young people saying, happy Mother's Day. Hallelujah. Can we do something here quickly? Can we do something here quickly? We're going to do the alphabet A to Z. And I want us to say something about the mother's touch. Okay, a mother's touch. If I say A, you give me a word that reminds you about your mother's touch with an A. Is that okay? Does that make sense? Okay, let me say, for instance, B. All right, okay. Now, this is what we are going to do. This is what you are going to do. Prepare a word that you have in your heart. In your heart. And then I'm going to stand here. When I say A, the A person comes and he says it and he passes. When I say B, the B person comes. Gonna see what you think about your mother. All right. Amen. Amen. Are we ready? Are we ready? A. No. You come here. You come here. You say it once on the mic and you go sit down. All right. So let's do it quickly. A.
Affirmative.
She gets an affirmative touch from her mother. B. B.
Bold. Bold.
A bold touch from the mother. C.
Compassionate.
Compassionate touch. Wow. And I'm happy. I'm happy. It's brothers who are coming. C. Oh, D. Come on. D.
Discerned.
Sorry, what did you say? A descending touch. Wow. E.
Engaging. My mom was engaging.
Wow. An engaging touch. F.
Fighter.
The touch of a fighter. My.
Favorable. Friendly.
Wow. G.
Gorgeous.
Grateful.
Graceful. Godly.
H, the touch of the mother, H. touch. Thank you.
Honest. Humorous.
Okay. Don't repeat yourself. I.
Intelligent.
Wow, intelligence touch. J.
Joyful.
You were here before?
No, sir.
Oh, joyful. Thank you. K.
Kind.
L.
L. Love.
Loving touch from come. You had something. What were you gonna say? Same word?
Love.
Okay. All right. M.
Marvelous
touch.
Majestic.
N. Quickly. N.
Noble
touch. Oh.
Obedient.
Obedient touch. Okay.
Observant
touch. Ooh. P.
Prayer warrior.
Touch of a prayer warrior.
Precious.
Precious touch.
Prayerful.
Hallelujah. Q. No, I don't want you to say anything. The mic is here with me.
Queen.
A queen's touch.
Quiet.
Yo, Sandy dictionary. R. R.
Reassuring.
Reassuring touch. Yeah, R.
Revolution.
Touch of revolution. Yo.
Reliable
touch. S. And I'm never out to be. S.
Superwoman.
Wow. Super touch. Superwoman.
Sophisticated touch.
Yo, sophisticated touch. T.
She's trustworthy.
Trustworthy touch.
Tenacious
touch.
Tender touch.
Whoa. You. You.
A mother is a unifier.
Unifying touch.
Unique
touch.
Understanding
touch. Alpha. What's next? Oh, V. Come on, V.
She's virtuous.
Vicious.
Vivacious.
Yeah. Vivacious. Abai Jaifel.
Victorious.
Victorious touch. W.
Wise.
Wise touch from mama. X.
Zenas.
Kawe. Why? Why? Please, Oscar, why? Why? Come. Why? 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 Why?
A youthful touch. Youthful.
Youthful touch. Yeah. Emma Mandeva gets old. She has a youthful touch. X. Or definitely X. Y. Okay, Z. Z. Come, Z.
She's zealous.
Zealous. That's a zealous touch. Thank you.
Zeta.
Zealous.
Serious touch. Oh.
Zestful.
Zestful touch. Come on. Let's give the mothers all that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Mothers, you bring a vibe in the church. Amen. You really bring a vibe to the church. And the children are also here. I'm going to ask them to come in. Are they here already? They are here already. They are okay. All right. All right. Okay. Okay.
Mother's Day.
Mother's Day is a celebration of your mother.
Mother's Day is when you love your mother so much you give her presents.
Mother's Day is when we honor our mother for everything that they do for us.
What do you love about your mom?
She's encouraging. She's loving and caring.
I love my mom because she takes care of me, and I love her because she plays a game called Roblox with me.
She's protected and loving.
What would you like to say to your mom this Mother's Day?
Thank you for everything you've done
for me. Mom, you're amazing. Thank you for taking good care of me.
Thank you for the food that you cook for me, and thank you for providing for me.
I appreciate you, Mom. You make the world a better place.
I love you, Mom.
Ngiyakuthanda, Mama.
Ngiyakuthanda, Mama.
Ngiyakuthanda, Mama.
I can sleep for your Mama.
Okay, I'm going to ask the mothers to stand and let the little ones bless you. Okay, all the mothers to stand, please. Let the mothers stand, please. It looks like the mothers this side are very special. They all just went that side. Amen, 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 amen. That's right, that's right, that's right. Let the little ones bless the mothers. Up to where they can, up to where they can, up to where they can. Hallelujah, hallelujah. As they give you something, you can say, so that your anointing to get gifts does not attract five gifts. Wow, wow, wow. God bless you. God bless you, little ones. God bless you. Wow, 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 wow. Wow. Mama. All right. All right. Okay, mothers, that's all that the children's church could put together. And Arba Shapelem Mato, Arba Shapelem Mato. Sure. Such a beautiful atmosphere, isn't it? Hallelujah. And from us as Men on Track, we just would love to say, KBC mothers, know that you are very special. And from the bottom of our hearts, we thank you for everything that you do for us. Everything you do for your family. Everything you do for your children. everything that you do for this country. Without you, life would be very dim. Mothers are the switch that brings warmth and light in the home. Amen. Hallelujah. You know what? When Pastor Veronica came back, there were people that said to her, "Thank you for coming back. The bishop looked very lonely when you were not here." I didn't know it was so obvious. So when the mother is not here, it is so obvious how lonely we become. Amen. I believe that this is going to be a very special service. Shall we all stand as we receive the word of the Lord this morning? Hallelujah. Every day and every hour, you are faithful. Oh, every day, every day. Yes, and every hour, you are faithful. We've seen you in our lives. You are faithful. Oh, God. You are faithful. Every day, yeah. Yes, and every hour.
The
Lord a big clap praise. Jabu. All right. And just smile with somebody. I know you did smile, but today is Mother's Day. We just need to smile. We just smile. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I just want us to get into an atmosphere so that the Spirit of God can minister to us today. Before I start, okay, I want you just to sing with Jabu and let our spirits just connect. Let us become one accord in the house. Hallelujah.
My beloved is the most beautiful among thousands and thousands. My beloved is the most beautiful among thousands and thousands. My beloved, come on, church. My beloved, most beautiful. Among thousands, and thousands, my beloved, most beautiful, among thousands, and thousands, all over this place, just call him Yeshua. Yeshua. Come on, lift up your voice and just call his name. Oh, what's his name? One more time. What's his name? Yeshua. Name above all names. Yeshua. Yeshua is your name. One more time. Call him Yeshua. Yeshua. Yeshua HaMashiach. Jesus the Messiah. Jesus the Messiah. Come on, somebody help me say, yours is the kingdom, yours is the power, yours is the glory forever. Come on, all over this place, say yours is the kingdom. Say yours is the power, yours is the glory. We call him Yeshua. Yeshua is your name. One more time, church, call his name, Yeshua. Yeshua is your name. Hallelujah. Jesus, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Yeshua is your name.
Come and call upon his name.
Hallelujah.
When you call upon his name.
Hallelujah.
He's there.
We call him Yeshua.
When we call upon him in your Yeshua. Situation is there. He's there. When you call Yeshua, Jesus, he knows about you. When you open your mouth, he already knows what your situation is, and that's so awesome. But he wants you to open your mouth, because in the name of Jesus, in that powerful name of Jesus, there is deliverance. And in that name, there's a solution for your situation. In that name, there is healing, if you need healing. So when you say Jesus, in Hebrew they say Yeshua, he stands and he waits for you to worship him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, take a moment and speak to the Lord. Take a moment and speak to God. You haven't spoken to God. You've spoken to yourself. And you've spoken to others. Open your heart to the Lord. He knows your heart. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Spirit of the Living God. Thank you, Jesus. We love you. We love you. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. You may sit down and give the Lord a clap. Praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Well, happy Mother's Day. It's a beautiful day. It's a day that mothers are appreciated all over the world. Not just here in South Africa, not just here in the country. But it's amazing that the whole world remembers mothers. Mothers who have been gifted by God to change lives, to change nations. God loves it when we honor mothers. He is a God that also shows us his motherhood side in the Bible. So he loves it when we treasure and honor our mothers. Today is a day that can be wonderful for some. And it's also, I know, a day that can be very difficult for some. I don't know if Bishop welcomed our online viewers. Thank you for watching. Praise the Lord. Thank you for tuning in this morning. Happy to have you online. And we pray that if you are a mother, that you will be blessed by what the Lord is serving here in the house in Koinonia Bible Church. Thank you for tuning in. Praise God. Now, as Bishop was going on with his little thing here, he had his own side show today. And that was beautiful. But I would just like to share a little quote. And these are from the children. You know, the children has got all these wonderful sayings. You just listen to it. So one was asking, one was telling the other one, what did the mother spider say to the baby spider? Okay, seeing that we're in a class today, what do you think the mother by a spider said? How soon a spider? You are too long on the web. Only the millennials will get it. Only the Zen generation will get it. But if you're born in the 60s, it will take long. It will take long. So please, moms and dads, we're living in an era where you have to guide your children on the way. I just want to start with that. Throw it in here. You've got to guide your children with those gadgets. Technology is good. We can use it for the glory of God. But now parents are sitting with a problem. When shall I buy Johnny a little device?
As a 2 years
old, 3 years old, those days when it came out, you know, there was age restriction, but not anymore. They come out of the womb already excited to see, you know, the buses. I don't know if they see anything in the womb, but nowadays technology is there, you know, I don't know what they shine inside. But there's no age restriction, so you've got to guide your children.
Please.
Nowadays, it is so tricky. They sit on the phone and things just pop up. Filters are so that you can filter what comes up on your child's device.
We're
having a huge problem with children. In the schools, they become violent. They feel that they are being ostracized if they're not on the web, if they're not socializing. You've got a big job. Moms, and those grannies who are looking after children, find somebody to help you. Because our children are being caught up in this thing. Fast-moving technology. And we have got to control it. We have to. Some children are getting hurt, they are in pain. And tragically, in some situations, it ends up in suicide. We read about lots of cases now. So I'm just throwing that thing in. If Donnie is too long on the web, you've got to get him off. Okay, but now it's very tricky. The schoolwork and everything has got to do. They have got to use technology, but now you have got to guide your child. That is just to throw in. So on this day, mothers, I've got a very simple message here. You all read the Bible, but it's beautiful if God comes along and he reminds us of who we are. When he reminds us what he requires of us. When he reminds us how we can walk in his blessings. When he reminds us how we can become strong in him. So today can be wonderful, it can be difficult to some have mothers, others don't. Some have got strange relationships with their mothers. Some don't have a relationship with mom at all. Young child, boy, a young man or young woman. Yeah, don't have relationship with moms at all. So for them, a day like this is not really wonderful. So there are different kinds of struggles that some faces in life that can make this day very terrifying and for some of us. Some enjoys it, but others don't. And they feel that it's not really a pleasant day to remind them of terrifying moments that they have with their mother. And they become very reluctant to meet people. So if you see somebody that is not really as joyful as you are, just understand.
Amen.
Just understand. But I pray that after this message, you shall be so encouraged. And I pray that as you came in here, very reluctant to meet people, that you will leave here very, very differently. So let's look at the book of Samuel, and let's look at First Samuel chapter 1 and verse 1. I just want to go through this passage, a very familiar passage. So 1 Samuel chapter 1 verse 1. You see, a godly mother is a growing mother. I entitled my message, A Godly Mother is a Growing Mother.
Okay,
so you can look at different ways. Yes, she grows in wisdom. A godly mother grows in knowledge and kindness. She grows in a spiritual life. And she grows in a relationship with God. So she grows, okay? But let's not go to the physical side. Okay? We know when we get to a certain age, our bodies expand. We grow a little bigger. And grow a little wider. Okay, that's the term. We just grow wider and bigger. So a godly mother grows. She's a growing mother. So in Samuel chapter one. We read verse 1 here. Now there was a certain man from Zamathan, a Zuphite, from the hill of country of Ephraim, whose name was Elkanah, son of Jeroboam, son of Eliud, son of whatever. And he had, verse 2, and he had two wives, who was called Hannah, and the other Peninnah. Peninnah had children, but Hannah had none. So year after year, this man went up from his town to worship and sacrifice to the Lord Almighty in Shiloh. Yeah, Hophni and Phinehas, the two sons of Eli, were priests. Take note of that. They were priests. Whenever the day came for Elkanah to sacrifice, he would give portions of meat to his wife, Peninnah, and to all his sons and daughters. But to Hannah, he gave a double portion because he loved her. The Lord had closed her womb. Now, because the Lord had closed Hannah's womb, her rival kept provoking her in order to irritate her. This went on year after year. So when Hannah went up to the house of the Lord, her rival provoked her till she wept and would not eat. Her husband Elkanah would say to her, Hannah, why are you weeping? Why don't you eat? Why are you downhearted? Don't I mean more to you than 10 sons? Okay, let's stop for there now. So Hannah here in the Bible was an example of a godly mother, and you will see why I'm saying that. In the Bible, she presents this pattern of a godly mother. So the nation was wicked, and God was looking for a leader with integrity. And it states here in chapter 1, it says here in verse 1, she was the wife of Elkanah, and the mother, and then, okay, she later on, you will see that she was the mother of Samuel.
Okay,
prominent prophet.
A prophet.
Yeah. Now, in this verse, where it says here that Elkanah had two sons.
I just want to bring your attention here.
So many, when they read this chapter, they ask the question, why was that now allowed?
So it differs
from culture to culture. There are cultures where it is allowed, where they have normal relations. And you know, other cultures, you know, follow the pattern in the Bible. So now Elkanah had his wives. So you want to know why was that allowed? But let me say to you, just to make it clear before we continue, that polygamy is not permitted in the Bible. So you're going to ask yourself, but there it was. But does God approve of it? No. No, that is why we must read the Bible. God does not approve of
polygamy.
You see, the standard God set in the Garden of Eden for the first marriage was that of monogamy. Monogamy was one man, one wife. And you can read in Genesis 2, verse 23. I'm just going to shorten this. The man said, this is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, for she was taken out of man. Verse 24, that is why a man leaves his father and mother and is united to his wife, and they became one flesh. The marriage union between a man and a woman, right in the Garden of Eden, God ordained that marriage. And that is accepted by God. Now Jesus Christ later reaffirmed that standard for his followers. When it came to the New Testament, when Jesus came, he came to reaffirm that standard for his followers. In Matthew 19, verse
4 to 6.
Here we read in the NIV. Haven't you read, he replied, that at the beginning the Creator made them male and female? And he said, the words of Jesus, for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife. The two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh therefore. What God has joined together, let no one separate. So Jesus came to reaffirm that standard. And that is why we say emphatically, no to polygamy. So a woman can't have five husbands. A man can't have five wives. If you are a child of God, you've got to follow the pattern in the scriptures. But according to culture, certain cultures, it is allowed. Society allows it. But you can see with this kind of arrangement, there's always lots of struggles and stresses that comes along with it. Along with polygamy comes its stresses. And we can see it in this chapter as we're going to carry on. So in the Bible we see Isaac, when he had his wife Rebecca, she could not conceive. But Isaac, take the matter to God. Now this is what the Bible encourages us. In every situation, we must take the matter to God. Amen. Take the matter to God. If you feel that you want another wife, you are a child of God, search the scriptures and take the matter to God. God will show you the way out according to his scriptures. But it was here where God had allowed it because of the desires of people. And in many homes that should go through it, it just caused problems and problems. Even Solomon with his many wives forbore in scripture. Don't have many wives. God forbid it in Deuteronomy. Because there he says, your heart will be drawn away from God and all of them. And it was just so. That is also something that I'm just going to put right here. So now Hannah comes out of this
dysfunctional family. Yeah, where Elkanah had Penina and
Mo
he had her.
Elkanah
the Bible says Penina, that she could not conceive. And her rival Hannah
Miss
was now
Sirasahai
really, really teasing her and provoking her.
Unanta
you know, a person, when you read the story, that this woman provoked her.
How about
and
Bibele
lost at her. And every time they go to worship, she lost at her. A person like that is really from the devil. You are influenced by a wicked spirit when you make fun of another woman's fertility. And I'm sure if Penina had social media,
was that Penina had social media,
she would have been texting all
around.
She would have splashed Hannah's things out there for all the trolls to comment.
But
it was the kind of Penina. But you see, then Hannah didn't open up her mouth. She just went crying. So now this lady, Hannah, turned to God for comfort. She knew that she was in a difficult space and she turned to God because she was childless in this marriage. She wasn't rude, but she went praying.
The
Bible says in John 16:33, Jesus says, you will have tribulations in this world. Certain things we bring on by ourselves in our lives and in our homes. But Jesus, in his grace, he says, you will have tribulations in this world. But then he promises a way out, that in that difficult times, you will not be alone. Go into your prayer closet, go onto your knees, and he will show you the way out. Many women were barren in the Bible. Some women struggled to conceive.
For
the word of God says in Psalm 127:3, children are a gift of God. So naturally, when a woman gets married, she says, take care of children, because she doesn't want to be ridiculed by society.
Or
society can be very cruel at times.
Oh,
they can question women in the name of concern. You know, that kind of concern, but it's a busy body concern. Children are a gift from God. So why are the abortion rates so high? In every society, every country, there's the abortion rate is climbing and climbing and climbing. Actually, because we're sitting with an enemy. We're sitting with an enemy who still hates the work of God. But God said to them there, the Garden of Eden, that Eden, that is the seed of the woman that will crush the head of the serpent. The devil tried everything in his power to destroy babies. Everything through scripture, because he didn't want the purpose of God to prevail. And he still continues to have babies aborted. That is why God hates abortion. It destroys the work of God. It is an abomination to God. Because in the womb, it's God that is at work. In the womb, God fashioned and God puts together his creation. And this is what the enemy comes to destroy. Hallelujah. Why do we say Hannah was a godly woman? Why do we say she was a godly woman? I say she was a godly woman because she had a good relationship with her husband. When they went up to Shiloh every year, she was there in her pain, in her barrenness. She didn't stay home. She went with her husband. Even though the other one was making fun of her, she went with him. And I see in this chapter that there was this mutual kind of worship of God, because they went to a place of worship together. Elkanah didn't leave her behind. He wasn't ashamed of her. When a husband loves his wife, it cements the relationship. So she was not at home. Although her home was a dysfunctional home. Yes, it was a dysfunctional home. But she obeyed her husband.
husband.
And a
husband deeply loved her.
Munna ya namu
rata
kautiba.
Because it says here. It says here. So when they go up to do the sacrifices, he would give Penina and her children. But to Hannah he gave double portions. Because he loved her. He loved her so much that he extended, he opened up his heart to her.
And
he said to her, concerned why she was weeping when she was with you. And she was there and he could see the pain she was in. And he said to her, why are you downhearted? Don't I mean more to you than
your son?
So he was the man who loved Hannah.
Maybe
Hannah was his first wife.
They
couldn't bear children, and then Penina was taken to bring the children along. So he was very concerned about Hannah. Hallelujah. Yeah, that was a loving husband. So a godly mother is a woman of a word.
So when we see here,
Hannah went up to Shiloh, and then after eating, she stood up that very day. Now, this was something they did annually. But now, there was something different. Something different came out of her. She stood up, the Bible says. She went to the doorpost. There was a
meeting
at the tabernacle. And then she started to pray. In deep anguish, she prayed to
her
God. And she was weeping. The Bible says she didn't pray loud.
But
only her lips were moving. But she was in deep connection with God. That the man of God wanted, he asked her, why when are you going to end this drunkenness of yours? He thought she was drunk, but she wasn't. She said, no, I'm not drunk, my Lord.
No.
I'm a woman that is crying before God. And then she told him that she is coming before God with her whole heart. She didn't leave anything behind, but she herself. She was singing Yeshua.
Answer Yeshua.
The Bible don't say that she mentioned Jesus yet, but she was in connection with God. God Almighty. For she prayed in such a powerful prayer that she called on the God Almighty, the Lord of hosts, the Lord of the
Jehovah of Mahota, Alehodimo.
And that is the prayer David prayed when he was going to slice off the head of Goliath. He came to Jehovah Shavuot, the God Almighty, the God of the armies. So she entered the prayer room differently. She didn't come in feebly. She came to consult with a powerful living God.
She
said, God Almighty. When you say God Almighty, you get the attention of heaven. The armies of heaven stand behind. What is it that we must do for you? Are we
going
to go into battle?
How
yes,
can I do?
Because the situation is serious. So Hannah went into that room and she was going to end it. She was going to say, today I'm pouring out.
Yeshua.
And it filled the room. She called.
A pizza.
That very moment. That very moment. And then she says in verse
11.
And she made a vow saying, Oh Lord Almighty. If you will look.
How
if you will only look. How on your servant's misery. And remember
how
me and not forget your servant. But
he
your son. And I will
give him
the
for the days of his life, that no razor will ever be used on his head. And she prayed that from the bottom of her heart, that Eli couldn't understand. She was deeply troubled. Eli thought she was a wicked woman. The priest that couldn't discern. The priest of the house couldn't discern. Because he sat on a big chair.
Do this to learn to pahaming.
So there, we see that the godly woman.
Rebona ramo sadia ya saba mudimo.
So as she was saying, "No, Lord, I will give him back to you." She made a vow to God, saying that if God granted her the son, that she will give him back. And the Bible says, I think it's verse
20.
So in the course of time, in due time, she became pregnant and gave birth to a son. And she named him Samuel,
Samuel,
because I asked the Lord for him. So she made a vow, yes, that she was
going
to give him back to the Lord. And Elkanah, and she worshipped the Lord. And then when the child was born, she said to Elkanah again, she's going to stay home, and she's going to wean the child. Now you know, children of God, you know, many times we ask God for blessings, and when God
starts
blessing, we see it all over. When God blesses, and when the blessing is there, and then people just step back. They
no longer
on fire for God. They move out. Couple of seats born here to the back door. God has blessed you with a house and a car, a beautiful job, a beautiful wife and a husband, and it's finished with God. But here we see that this godly woman, she, the Bible portrays as a woman of her word. When the child was born, she said to Elkanah, she's not going to go with him down to the place of worship. Not that she was backing out. No, she wasn't backing out. She was going to weep. She was going to wean the boy. She was going to stay in a place so that she can mold him from birth to that little age. She wanted to mold him. And I believe the Spirit of God was behind that, because this was not a child, an ordinary child. This was a child given by Almighty God for the purpose of God. So Elkanah understood the beautiful relationship they had, the husband that understood, they had mutual agreement in this relationship. They had mutual, he didn't lord it over her, he didn't abuse his wife, he didn't use his religious whip, he understood, and she weaned the boy. So Elkanah went back, and Hannah stayed home. Sometimes we must know also our priorities in ministry. Priorities in ministry. You can't give more in the ministry
and
your children goes wayward. We must have that balance. You need to be a minister first at home, and then minister to others and the world. You can't neglect your children in this day and time. That is why I say you've got to guide your children. If they sit too long on the web, you've got to know what's going on there. Let me just bring the story over to you. There was a woman one day, and she went running around. The Lord blessed her mightily. She had a powerful ministry, and she had a dream. And in this dream, she saw many faces and hands.
And
every time she says, no, I must go there,
the
Lord needs me then. She
must
travel there, she must
fly
there. But still, she would get the street.
And didn't go
she would get these places. And she inquired of the Lord and there was no answer. God doesn't answer me, then I must go there. And I must go preach there, because I'm the woman of God. And one day, as she was sitting in a lounge, she was reading the Bible. She became quiet before the Lord. And in comes the sons,
her
wayward boy. Riddled in drugs and
booze.
And she saw them coming in
the
early hours of the morning. But she didn't see her boys the way she used to see
them.
Behind the alcohol, behind the drugs. She saw the pain in the eyes of the
sons.
She saw their longing. They just want a relationship with their godly mother. And then the Holy Spirit showed her. You go all over.
We are holy, Mona.
But you haven't
had
a relationship with your children. That's the message she got from the Lord. God wants us to balance. Prioritize. God needed the woman to be at home. He needed her to give, to mold the spirit, to shape him, to make him ready for the temple. She wanted a boy, someone said. She wanted a son, but God wanted a leader for Israel. Because
Israel,
at that time, Israel was, the nation was so wicked. There was no leader. Everyone did what was right in his own eyes. From politics right into the pulpit. Eli was the priest, but he wasn't in the right place. God needed to put things right for his chosen people. And he prepared a womb. He wanted not just anybody. He wanted a godly person. He wanted a sensitive person. He wanted a person that would humble herself. He didn't want a rude woman. He didn't want a woman who's all over social media and slander others. He wanted a new, a humble heart for his purpose. He found that in Hannah. And he found it in her. She understood that she must stay home. But she loved the place of worship. But there were certain things that she did in this little boy. And she went back one day. She went back. And the Bible says, when the boy was weaned, he was ready to be taken back. He was not fully grown, but he was now ready. Ready, as small as he was, he was now ready to go and serve God. Because she made a vow. She prayed unto the Lord. And she said, I will bring it back. How many of us make a vow and then we don't honor what we say to God? And we say, this is what I, and we think this is what we said in a very religious atmosphere. And when we leave the prayer room, our prayers are answered, and we forget. And we don't come back. We don't follow back. But not this woman. This was a godly woman who knew that when she speaks before the Lord, she speaks before a holy God. She made a vow.
Now
the Bible says in Ecclesiastes 5:4-6, when you make a vow to God, this is in the Bible, Ecclesiastes 5:4, when you make a vow to God, do not delay to fulfill it. It has no pleasure in fools. Fulfill your vow. And verse 5, it is better not to make a vow than to make it is better not to make a vow than to make one and not to fulfill it.
Do not let
your mouth
lead you into sin.
So if you've made a vow to God, and you haven't honored it, bow your knee and repent. So that God can bless you
in all
of your life. So year after year she made year after year she made these sleeveless coats for the little boy. And then she took it to him. So she blessed her child. The Bible says she blessed him. She went there day after day. I mean, year after year, she went to go and check up on him. And he was in the house of God. And mother would see, go and see. Is my boy okay? Does he have clothes? Does he have enough to eat? She was constantly checking up on him. And that is the godly heart. She didn't just throw a child out there and then forget about him.
And
somebody can take care of him. She followed it up. She would take all that what is necessary to the house of the Lord. And then the godly mother that she was, she went in 1 Samuel 2. Her heart was so exalted to the Lord that she praised him. She didn't keep quiet, she praised him. And praised him here in chapter 2. She says, then Hannah prayed and said, my heart rejoices in the Lord. In the Lord of my in the Lord my horn is lifted high. She praised God because her strength was lifted. When she came out of a prayer closet, when she came out that very day, the Bible says Hannah was changed. She was completely changed. It wasn't just an ordinary prayer. It was a prayer where she worshipped and she God, and she was pulled into the very throne room of her God. And she came out a worshiping mother, a praising mother, and she knew, I don't know how it's going to work out, but God is
going
to work it out. All she did, she was praising God.
And she wrote there
in chapter 2,
Jehovah.
The Bible says, praise the Lord continually.
With
the lips of our mouth, praise him. A godly mother here today that the Bible reminds us of. And this is Hannah. Conclusion here. Now, I just want to show you out here. It's such a beautiful, deep passage in the Bible. Every time you read it, the Holy Spirit shows you different things, the principles of God. Every time you read it,
First Samuel,
chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, we see now another family. I'm concluding. Another family. And the Bible makes us to observe the family of Eli. Eli was the high priest. He had two sons, Hophni and Phinehas. And they were priests in the house of the Lord.
And
the Bible says that those two young priests, they were wicked. They were so bad. They did all the speakable things.
Bets and truths is so
they
the
women in the church. They took the sacrifice that people brought to the Lord for repentance. Because when people want to repent, they would bring a sacrifice. And they would come and put their forks in and take whatever
happened.
When the meat was not even properly cooked, they wiped it
out.
Very bad to boys. And then you know what? God said that he is going to kill them. Now that was very strong coming from a loving God. Why would a loving God say directly there
God judged them. Because God was appalled to see that kind of behavior. And he said, I'm going to judge the house of Eli. I'm going to kill the fool. God didn't say how. He didn't say how.
This
was another family. The house of Eli. Eli would speak to his boys. Yes, he did. He said, why do you do such things about here? But the boys didn't pay attention. He just said, you mustn't do these kind of things. People are speaking badly.
But
you are doing bad things. But the boys just continued. Now the Bible says that God says Eli didn't restrain his children. Does the Bible mention a mother here? No. In Eli's house, maybe there was a mother. We don't know what kind of mother. We don't know because these children didn't just fall out of the sky. They came through the womb of a woman. So where was the woman? It only mentions Eli and the children that he can't restrain. So this dude was out of line. They were in the church, but they're doing all their wicked things. And that didn't go well with God. Now, this was the family of Eli. They were bad. Now God was going to kill them. And as you read the story here in chapter 4, the Bible says that the Israelites went to war and they were defeated. And then they came back. Hophni and Phinehas were priests. Then they were in war with the Philistines. And then they took the Ark of the Lord. The Ark of the Lord represents the presence, the power of God. And they thought they're going to be protected. Their hearts were so wicked around the presence of God. And then God allowed the enemy to defeat them. And the Ark was taken out of the nation. And here was the nation now without the power of God. And within that war, God was true to his word, and he had that two boys killed. And when the word came back to the father that the ark was taken and the boys were killed, your son, he fell off the chair, and the Bible says he broke his neck. God judged the whole family. The whole family, a very different family. They were in the house of God, but they never respected God. They sinned, and the boys sinned intentionally. They didn't do it, they did it deliberately. God. And the nation suffered. Because the house of God wasn't in the right place, the nation suffered. A family wasn't in the right place, and the nation suffered. Now the ark was captured and was taken to the Philistines. And then the Bible says the glory of God departed. The glory of God departed because of a wicked family called by God to stand in the gap for the nation. But there the ark and the glory is gone. And the nation suffered. Calling families back together to pray. Pray for the nation. Pray that God's hand rule over the nation. The presence of God was no longer with him. The Bible says, but the glory of God came down because of one family. One family that God chose. A mother who stood. A mother's prayers who made a difference. A mother's prayer who brought about a man of God who came to lead the nation back to God. God wants his people back. He wants his people back. He's looking for mothers to stand and pray. Pray over your children so that he can bring leaders into the nation and lead the nation back to God. Samuel came on the scene. He was a blessing to the nation. But Eli's family. Eli's family. From the line, the chosen line of prayer.
priests.
They couldn't walk with integrity.
They
couldn't walk faithfully before God. And God is still looking today for men and women to stand in the gap for him, to continue to lead the nation into righteousness. So which family do you want? Eli's family
that
greed, the power, the money, and the prestige in ministry, do you want that? Or do you want the family of Hannah, God-fearing woman? A family who put God first. A family where there was mutual worship. A family where there was love and prayer. A family who knew their priorities. A woman who trusted God.
She
trusted Jehovah Shabbat. Do you want that family?
No, but
do you want that family?
Oh,
then you've got to do what Hannah did. A godly woman. God is reminding us what a godly mother should be like. A godly mother teaches her children right from wrong.
Proverbs
1, verse 8. A godly mother nurtures the children, she provides for children, she speaks truth into darkness. A godly mother shares even what she has. Even if it is a law, she will do that. And God is reminding us, a godly mother for kids, a godly mother for kids and let go. A godly mother has reverence for God. A godly mother stands in the nation.
We are being
and speak for God. Godly mother says no to what is ungodly. A godly mother don't sit on the internet, don't sit on social media and use her mouth in what is ungodly. Godly mother's life lives self-controlled lives. Self-controlled lives. They can control themselves.
When
the situation is out of hand, they're not going to speak like Penina. They restrain themselves. They have got self-control. This is the godly woman. A godly woman, I speak today to your church. Both her life and her home on the solid foundation of Jesus Christ.
Matthew 7, verse 27.
She's a wise builder. She builds. She hears from God. And she goes and do. In her home, in society, and elsewhere. The foolish builders hear the word of God, but they don't live by it. Mothers are important today. Mothers are important to the family and to society. You are important to God. You are important to God. Mothers are the makers of men and women. So protect your womb. Teach your daughters. Teach your children to protect their womb. If your relationship with your mother is a difficult one, you must know that she played an essential role in your life. If she did something to you, forgive her. That is what God wants from you. Your mother was given to you by God. Bless her. Bless her. Always. Don't wait for Mother's Day. Bless your mother.
Amen. Let's all stand, church. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. As we hear this song from the team, just take time to pray for your house. Whatever is happening in your house, if you are the cost of it, come before the Lord with repentance. If you are a child that is causing
headache and pain in your family. Sometimes we do that even coming to church. But today, after this word, humbly come before the Lord. If you are a mother in this service today,
and
things are not going right in your house, there's an atmosphere under this word today. Even as Hannah came before the Lord, you come before the Lord today. If you are the man in the house, things are not going right in your house, and you know deep down in your heart you are the cause, come before the Lord as the worship team is singing.
Worshiping team is Sabina.
Don't sing. Come before the Lord. If things are right in your house, thank the Lord for that miracle. Thank the Lord for that beauty. Thank the Lord for the direction of your children. One thing we don't do right as human beings, we don't have the foresight of the future, that what we are doing here today is
going
to hit the next generation. You may be enjoying it whilst it is wrong, but those who are coming behind you will suffer because of it. So today, let's come before the Lord. Let's come before the Lord. And let's worship the Lord together. We thank the Lord for such a powerful
moment.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
There is no other that saves but the name of Jesus Christ.
Just pray where you
there
are.
Is no other.
Thank you, Jesus. May the Lord bring correction. May the Lord bring change. May the Lord bring transformation. May the Lord bring healing. Just pray where you are in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
There is no other.
There is no
but the name.
That's right. If you want to come and pray here in the front, just take whatever you bag, whatever, and you come and kneel here in the front and you pray.
There is
thank
no
you,
other.
Jesus.
By the name of Jesus.
There is no other name.
By the name of Jesus. By the name of Jesus. By the name of Jesus. There is no other.
Jesus,
by
Such a great ministry of your word. We beseech thee for healing, Father. Healing in our homes. Healing upon our spouses. Healing upon our children. Healing upon the destiny of our nation. You started the family, for you want the family to be the basis, to be the place where the warmth of the nation can be felt, where the beauty of the nation can be shaped. And today, we thank you for such a powerful word in our midst, and that it will start in our homes in the mighty name of Jesus. Now we pray for the change that is desired. We pray, Father, that as your children have come before you, Lord, to lift up their family before you, that they will see the move of your hand upon their families. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Whilst our heads are bowed in this place, if you are here in the service and Jesus Christ is not the Lord of your life, is not the Lord of your life, you have not given your life to Jesus, you have not accepted him as your Lord and personal Savior, and after sitting under the word of God today, the Lord has shown you the mirror of yourself, that you need cleansing through the Son. You need salvation in the name of His Son. And you want to come and accept the Lord in your life. We're going to call you to come to the front. Just come to the front so that we pray with you. Just come to the front so that we pray with you. Just come to the front so that we pray with you. Good morning. Kimodimo, kimone, kimodimo, kimone, 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 kimodimo, kimone. Kimodimo, kimone, kimone, kimone. That's right, just come forward. We tenula huena hona jwale, just come. Just come, just come. That's right, just come, just come.
Kimodimo, kimone, kimone.
That's right, just come. God bless you. You may have watched this service on the telecast.
You
may
have been listening to the telecast.
Hallelujah. We just want to thank the Lord for the ladies that have come here and
You can come as well.
Glory to Jesus. Hallelujah. Lentsela mora ka mantsona thapelo re morena Jesu. Lentsula hao.
Lentsula hao.
Amile pelo yaka. Ke a bona.
Ke a bona.
Hore ke a o hloka.
Ke a dumela.
O shwetse di betsaka. O tsuhile bafung.
O
rena ka ho sa feleng.
O rena ka ho sa feleng.
Hlatswe ka madi a hao.
Hlatswe ka madi a hao.
Ke be mwana wa hao.
Ke
a leboha.
Ke a leboha.
Ka pholoso.
Ka pholoso.
Yo mphanyona.
Yo mphanyona.
Tshwarelo ya dibe.
Tshwarelo
ya dibe. Yo mphanyona.
Yo mphanyona.
Bophelo bo botjha.
Bophelo bo
botjha. Bo mphambona.
Bo kamoso. Bo kamoso.
Bo mphambona.
Bo mphambona.
Ke tla o sebeletsa.
Ke tla o sebeletsa.
O tlo alta sila ka Jesu.
Ka
Jesu Kriste
morena. Ka Jesu
Kriste. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. We give the Lord a big hand of praise. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Ke go bafela le Salem me wa rona morao. Atle a tse go lebolella rona house wa morena Jesu o etsa jwang. Amen. Just follow her, please. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Glory to Jesus. Hallelujah. I just feel an atmosphere of worship in my heart. Hallelujah. Amen. You are holy, my Lord. You are holy. You are holy, my Lord. You are holy. Yes, you are holy. Lord, you are holy. You are holy, my Lord. You are holy. You are holy. You are holy,
my Lord.
You are holy.
We bless you, Jesus. And no one compares to you. No one is like unto you, Lord. Thank you for your unction over this place this morning. Shalom alemon de Rebecca Nan Robe Mamanande la Basade Bodo Letete Macapene Doreba Hanel Messi Lidia Mandolo La Lebende Ravanda Viviasa Catalaboade Shene Membre Lebendolo Mosta just tarry in his presence. Just tarry in his presence. Just allow him. Just allow him to minister to you. She me melekete tanani etarebo babana kesa. Yembre loda de bahande makatete salabaya ribashata. Yes. Allow the Holy Spirit to move the burden from your shoulders. Malibose tani mande kasata rabashata. Allow him to heal you. Allow him to heal you. Shalabo de bahande la masita. Yebre monde la bakatana mahiete. Yes. Allow him to deliver you. Allow him to set you free. Allow him to minister to that pain that is in your life. Milose malita tatana morabea kesalabota. Enda labusi katalabahe sakita. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Ikazi mulo ya kikwele amazulu no ikazi mulo ikazi
Kazimulo ya kwikwele, amazulu,
seated.
Regadula Fati.
Something is happening. It's happening to all of us. Glory to Jesus. Just open your heart and allow the Lord to minister to you. Just open your heart and allow the Lord to minister to you.
As I've come to take a seat now, and Bishop is talking here. The Spirit of God is being blocked out. It's being blocked out. It's not going to benefit you. The shame that you feel, even at the feet of Jesus. For the Lord is showing me here, it is relational issues. You cannot relate clearly with your husband in the house, with your children. There's a breakdown in the relationship in the house, and it's making it difficult for you to respond to the word of God. God is speaking to you. And he wants to give you the release. He wants to give you the way forward. It will not come right unless you lay it at the feet of Jesus. It doesn't matter what you have said. The word that came out of your mouth. God is a forgiving God. If you have that relational issue with your spouse, whether it be a man with his wife or a woman with her husband, a woman with the children, and a man with the children, or if it's a friend and a friend today, God wants to restore your relationship and your attitude towards him. You to the front so that you can be delivered. God wants to help you so that his spirit can flow freely. Know who you are. You know who you are. Do it today. On this Mother's Day. And be healed in your body. And be healed. The headache that you sit with. Of this. The back pain that you sit with. Because of the relational issues. God wants to heal you. Today. So come forward. We will graciously pray with you. Thank you, Jesus. We will graciously pray with you. Thank you, Jesus.
Madi Jale
Madi Ali Jehova. Oh, sweet.
thank you, Jesus, for appointing this day to heal homes, to heal relationships, to heal fathers, to heal mothers, to heal sons and daughters. Thank you for the miracle that you are doing in this place here today. Just keep on interceding where you are. Just keep on interceding where you are.
Himba chwale ufedile adi chwale. Shwale Ali Shwale Ufedile Adi Shwale Ali Fide Ali Fide Ufedile Adichwale Ali Fide Ali Fide Ufedile Adichwale Ali Fide Ipachwale Ipachwale
Maria Shepso Ali Fide Ali Shwale
Ali Shwale
Ali Shwale Ali Fide
Ali Fide
Ipachwale
appreciation one more time. The Lord bless you, Pastor Veronica. Thank you so much.
For Pastor Veronica.
To minister that which the Lord has laid upon your heart. Thank you, Jesus. We're going to give unto the Lord. And as we do that, the account number of the check is on the screen.
Account number is on the screen.
And if you need an envelope for your
envelope
offering,
you
can just your hand
and the
ushers will pass an envelope to you as we give unto the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for this precious moment that we can stand in your presence by faith to sow, to give, to thank you, and Lord, to set our horizons on high, knowing that we can say Ebenezer, and tomorrow Ebenezer, and the day thereafter, Ebenezer, for you are the God who is manifested every time and is present in our situations, in Jesus' mighty name. So bless your children, bless their families, bless my God their businesses, bless Father their dreams, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. The Lord bless you as we give. Is this service ending or beginning? Hallelujah. Okay, let me make these clear announcements now. Hallelujah. Mothers, you know that we love you, ne? They are not saying anything. Okay. Okay. Is it a yes or a no? Mothers, you know that we love you, ne? Okay, so immediately when we finish this service, we're going to open a door there into the chapel and there into the chapel. So we're going to have two ways to go into the chapel. We prepared a cake for each one of you. And something to drink.
Listen, no.
So that might be a coffee or tea, or water. So you go there. You take what you take. You sit down. You finish. Okay, it's not very elaborate. It's not like a sponge cake or it's something just would make you to know that KBC loves you. Amen. So you're going to have a short fellowship there. So whatever you take, just because others be you. And then you can shoot straight home. Because if the church can put that little, then go hide the hole.
It means there's something greater at home
for Mother's Day. Amen. Amen. Now, as you go there, I'm going to ask all the men and the brothers to occupy that last section there at the back.
We have a small talk.
You know, it's 10 minutes and then we are done. So, the mothers will queue there.
I know that women will help you quick when you are not a man.
They'll help you very quick. Hallelujah. Oh, what a lovely service, eh? Come on, let's stand and receive the benediction. Let's stand and receive the benediction. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, your presence in our midst has been so awesome. Stay, continue to be awesome in our lives. Let the love of God, the Father, and the fellowship, and your fellowship be more and more expounded, loud in our lives. And the grace of Jesus to help us to make impact through and through. We give you all the honor and the glory, and let the church say amen. Hallelujah. Okay, let's